Hello and welcome to Liverpool Community Podcast. My name's Phil Beale, I'm your host for today. And in the studio with us today, we have a fascinating lady who has made her way all the way over from Oslo in Norway. And she's a fabulous artist, and so I'd like to welcome, please, the wonderful Natalie Abel.
Thank you. Hi. What's going there?
That's a bit croaky, wasn't
it? Always singing all day long. Yeah. You know, Mariah Carey does that. She walks around the house. She's like,
what, doing the dusting?
Yeah, she just like never stops.
Vacuuming.
It must be so annoying to other people. I'm like walking around the house. I'm like, hello. Yeah. That's literally how I greet people when I enter a room. And if people are tired, they're like, again.
Well, good to meet you and welcome to the Big Condo Studio.
Thank you so much. It's
good to
be here.
You're very welcome. I mean, we came into connection with each other because you appeared recently, didn't you, at one of our events at around the corner mm-hmm. venue. So it was the Women in Music event, wasn't it?
Yes.
So how was that for you?
It was great. It was so fun. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you so much for the opportunity. It was great to be there, surrounded by so many cool women. And it was just a very supportive environment, cool venue, a lot of smoke. It was great. Felt like I was at a proper rave, you know? Yeah. So I performed a lot of my own music. I performed one of my songs, a song called Heading for Clouds.
Right, okay.
And that one I released last March. Yeah. Performed a few new songs that I want to put on my EP because I kind of have 7 songs planned for my EP. Awesome. Coming up this summer. Awesome. But could also be a bit delayed, depending on a few studio sessions that I've planned for the next few months. So,
Fabulous. So as people now have heard you speaking, we'll obviously have picked up your very broad...
It's a bit of everything in here, isn't it?
Accent. Irish accent. So just tell us a bit about the background to that.
I mean, I can't really control it. I'm not going to lie.
Fascinating.
It just comes out. So a lot of people think I'm Irish. Some people think I'm American.
Nobody thinks you're from Liverpool.
No, not really. Well, when I'm a bit drunk,
I
start saying I'm Maisel. Because I'll be chuffed, you know. And I find Scousers wild funny, so...
They're great.
I love the banter humour here. I live for it. At first, like, if you banter with a Norwegian person, they're like, right, calm down. But getting into it, it's like, it's so fun.
It takes a little while, doesn't it?
Yeah, but people don't take each other so seriously here. They're just having a laugh.
That's absolutely right.
I love it.
So what brought you over from Oslo then?
Music, really, yeah. It was music. I was going to do dance because I love dance and acting as well. Done a bit of musical theatre back home. And then I spoke to my vocal coach. She recommended Lipa. I applied and then I got in. I was like, I better go now.
Amazing, yeah. Mm. So have you found the Lipa experience then?
Great. It's lovely. There's so many amazing people from all over the world. So it's so great to be surrounded by so much talent and different cultures. And it's just...
Fantastic.
So it's really good.
Is it a 3-year course you're doing there?
Yes.
And whereabouts are you on that now?
I'm nearly done now, a few months.
And then
last year.
Oh,
so
wow,
graduation
amazing.
Concert in May and then fantastic. I'm off.
So has the great Paul McCartney made any appearances while you've been there yet?
No, he hasn't actually. Well, I had a bit of an odd first year with the lockdown and everything. But he will make an appearance in July at graduation.
So he's gonna be there, is he?
I've been trying to think, what do I say? Like
Fantastic.
I'll probably let it be. I won't say that because it's a horrible joke. Probably gets that a lot. I take that back.
That's going to be amazing, though, isn't it?
Yeah, amazing. It's going to be great. I really like his music.
I was about to ask you that. Did the Beatles influence you at all in what you do?
Yeah, well, I grew up with it. So, like, my grandmother, she's actually also, like, a big influence and the reason why I started writing because she does music as well. Well, did. And she used to just always play Beatles in the car. Growing up, it was just a constant. So even when I was sleeping, it was Beatles, you know?
I had the same experience, which is just wonderful. Do you write stories or do you write from life?
I like writing both. I always like to have a character for each song that I write. And sometimes I take inspiration from my own life events. But then I go, this isn't me. This doesn't happen. I hope if people don't think that. So I always like to make a full character. And since I love acting as well, that's kind of what I get my inspiration from. And I just love Adele. So I think what she did is super, super powerful. Like her just raw honesty is something very powerful. So I kind of wrote it as like an interpolation to someone like you, actually. And took a lot of inspiration from that.
So you mentioned Adele. We've talked about the Beatles briefly. Who else has influenced the way you were?
Definitely Queen. Definitely Freddie Mercury. I think just his way of performing and the way he captures the stage and the way he takes the audience on a journey is like exactly what I want to do with my music. Transport people to a different place and make them dance and self-liberation, self-expression.
So what about the actual writing process itself? Is there a method to it for you, or is it instinctive? Does it always come music first, or does it always come words first, or is it a variety of ways?
It's very music first, and melodies come very natural to me. A constant motion, but then it's actually like fitting the words into the melody. I like psychology, and I'm interested in like transcendence and stuff like that. So I write down a lot of things that I find fascinating about human psychology, and then I just look at my notes, and then I kind of just find words that fit into the melodies that I'm writing and the emotion I'm trying to express.
Have you got any idea or theory on where it comes from?
No.
Are you just one of those lucky people that can do that? Or
I think melodies for me are obviously very inspired by what I'm listening to.
Right.
So, and I feel very inspired by other people. And if I've done like a session or a rehearsal, I just find that it inspires me a lot and that I just have to sit down and write for a bit.
Fabulous. Okay. So are you working in a variety of idioms? Are you working with other people or solo totally, or how are you working?
I love collaborations and I love working with other people, and I find that it just always inspires me, and I have so many of my friends that just inspire me daily. My friend Cleo included, with the Irish accent, clearly. And
you've got to get Cleo in here to do one of these. She's crazy.
Check her out, she's great. And then so I always learn something from writing with other people. And I mainly write soul music myself, but I also like to write rock.
Right.
So I'm in this rock band called Revival, where I just do a lot of co-writes. So
local bunch, are they?
I've been getting a lot into just like writing for other people as well, and trying to put myself in their shoes. And it's a very liberating experience, because you also don't feel like something very personal is out there. It's just like, I don't know. More like work, and trying to put yourself in someone else's shoes is a very cool experience.
So would you say that your style's changed at all over time?
My style?
Yeah.
Yes, a lot. It's definitely been getting more narrowed, and I've been working a lot on just my writing, but I think my next step forward is just like really narrowing my sound and giving away the songs that I'm writing, which I don't feel like are mine. And just
maybe call it refining.
I like that word.
Fabulous. So what do you work on primarily? You said piano is one of your main instruments.
That's where I write the most, but depends on what kind of style I want to go for.
So tell us a bit more about Norway then. Come on then, give us a bit about your background in Norway and your career was progressing over there. I'm fascinated in the difference as well from your experience now of the UK compared to Norway.
Yeah, I mean, it's a very different culture. And I think in relation to the Women in Music Showcase as well, it's very interesting, because Liverpool has kind of taken me out of my shell. I find that in Norway, it's like more difficult to kind of stand out and be loud and proud as a woman as well. It's like people can be quite shy and very polite and scared of stepping on people's toes. People don't give a shit here. And I love that. I'm just more built for that kind of thing. And yeah, I love that culture. And so it's a very liberating experience to and very inspiring to be writing here.
Lovely. I mean, I personally think it's one of the greatest cities in the world.
Me too. Yeah, me too.
I feel so privileged to be working in Liverpool. Mm. I never dreamed it would ever happen.
No, no. It's fantastic. And it's like, it's so small, which is great as
well. It is, that's right. I mean, I don't know about Oslo. Birmingham, where I'm from, obviously, is huge.
Yeah, and Oslo is four times bigger than Liverpool, so... Yeah.
So it's a bit villagey in a way, isn't
it? It is.
Obviously, that's not in any way a criticism or a denigration.
No.
It's a wonderful city in its own right, but... Mm. It's like a village. Everybody knows
it. It is, and it's great.
How are you doing?
I'm friends with the local kebab mommy. Generally, we exchange emails and send each other music daily.
That's awesome.
It's good. It's good. Would never happen in Oslo. People would be like, "Is she okay?" So yeah, I love that. And Oslo is good. I mean, music career. I think it started with dance because I love dancing.
Is Oslo on the coast? Is it a port, Oslo?
Yeah, it's right, like, it has, like, a harbour, so it's right down south,
Right, okay, sorry to interrupt you. Okay,
I
just wonder if there's a similarity there.
There is. I do feel like it's a little bit, like, the docks is a little bit, like, occupied in Oslo, so, yeah.
So you obviously studied into your senior years in Oslo, and were you studying music at school as well?
Yes, I went to a music college.
Right, cool.
I did, and it was helpful, and I loved it, and made a lot of connections, and a lot of them also do music today, which is really fun. But yeah, I did a lot of dance. I went to this dance academy for a while, and that inspired me a lot to write as well, and there's a lot of cool musical theatre people there, and... Yeah.
That's interesting. And I believe you entered a competition.
Yes, I did. Oh, you've done your research, you?
Oh, yes. I've done a lot of digging.
I was at Norway's Got Talent in 2019.
Amazing.
And it was a very, I learned a lot. It was a very good experience.
Ain't no way for me to love you if you won't let me. Ain't no way for me to give you all the things you
So it's been fascinating to meet you.
You too.
And just let me ask you a more general question, maybe. How would you define the power of music for you personally?
I think it's extremely powerful. It's for me, it's actually been, it's saved my life many times.
Has it really?
It has. And I think it can do that for other people as well. And I think it's so, so powerful and that thing of like, it can transport you to a different place as well, and it can increase empathy and connection. And it's like, no matter where you're from, you can connect through the language of music. And
Really is an international language, isn't it? Yeah. Are there any Norwegian artists that influence what you do?
I love Aurora, Sigrid, Astrid S. Sarah Larsson is actually Swedish. I love her too. Cool. They're like the main ones right now.
Yeah. Mm. They're new to me, those names.
Yeah, they're quite new. Yeah. They've been like up there for the past 5 years, I'd say.
Yeah, cool. Well, it's been great to meet you. Absolutely fantastic. And I really wish you all the luck in all your coming endeavours. Artist management, that's something I never thought you'd be talking about. But yeah, that's a fascinating ambition to have.
Thank you.
So it's been fabulous, and good luck in all you do. And this has been the Liverpool Community Podcast with me, Phil Beale, and once more, the fantastic Natalie Abel. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you so much. See you in the next one.
Absolutely.